I tell my mother tell her family lawyer trying to get a deferment for my younger brother. Tell the Reverend Harris to pray for me, Lord, Lord, Lord. I don't believe I'm gonna live to get much older. Strange little man over here in Vietnam, I ain't never seen. Bless his heart, I ain't never done nothing to. He done shot me in my shoulder. You know we talked about fighting every day. And looking through rosy colored glasses. I must admit it seemed exciting. In a way, yeah, but something that they overlooked to tell me, Lord. Bullets look better, I must say. At you, but go it out the other way. And please call up the Reverend Harris. Tell him to ask the Lord to do some good things for me, Lord. Oh. Tell him I ain't gonna live to get much older. Shot me in my shoulder.
That's Bill Withers with I Can't Write Left-Handed, live at Carnegie Hall, one of my favorite albums of all time. One of the most moving songs of all time, I think, as well. Bill's really good at that. It's beautiful. I mean, that whole album is great. I mean, I've chosen a bunch of live recordings, and it's partly coincidental, but they just happen to be my favorite versions of those artists. And it also ties in with the fact my last three releases have been, well, two of them have been absolutely live concerts, and one was recorded as live in the studio. And it seems to me that I know as a fan of someone else, that's really what I want to hear more than a studio album, you know. And it seems the same for people that want to buy my stuff. The responses I'm getting to my last three albums have been greater than anything before. People have really gotten into the fact that it's raw and it's live and everything is left as is, which I've always tried to capture in the studio. I've never really overly produced anything, but it's always been recorded pretty much live in the studio, but these are actual live records. You know?
Yeah, we had to wait a long time between Candy Store Kid and One Man and His Guitar.
Two whole years, I think.
Yeah. 2 years is a long time.
Well, I brought out three. It's like a bus. I brought out three at once. And I've done two others on the side as well. So,
of course,
you know,
people, people won't have heard the new album, Night in Amsterdam.
No.
Which is some album. I have heard it.
Thank you.
If not only for the for Dusty on there.
Who?
And his guitar.
It's all me. What are you talking about? Yeah. That's just my pseudonym.
For people that don't know, Ian is backed by a Dutch band called the Rhythm Chiefs, who average an age of about...
12.
About 12. Quite interesting to see him shepherd them round like a mother hen, cooking for them as they vacantly stare into space and do nothing. Apart from getting on stage and being incredibly tight. And Dusty Cigar... Which is his real name?
That's his real name, yeah.
How do you get a name like that? It's fantastic.
Well, you're not going to be an accountant, are you?
No. Well, I was born Howling Dick.
Yeah, of course you were.
His guitar work is sensational, isn't it?
Joe, I'm not just saying this. I honestly think he's the best guitar player. He's certainly the best guitar player I know. I don't mean that to offend any other... I mean, I've worked with some amazing people. But Dusty's breadth of playing is insane. It's pretty much... Every door is open to every avenue is open to him. It's hard to describe, but he's got a unique style. I just think he's the best guy around, so I'm very lucky to be there.
Ladies and gentlemen, Dusty Cigar, I can tell you that.
I've heard him play jazz, Tex-Mex. Yeah. I mean, nothing's off limits, is it?
Nothing at all.
Effortlessly.
Absolutely. I don't think he practices at all. It's really annoying.
Well, that's an interesting... Do you practice?
Well, no, I don't, but I'm not a maestro.
You're always gigging.
I gig a lot, yeah. I guess maybe if I didn't gig so much, maybe I would practice, but I never really have practiced much, but you can probably tell. My playing is very, very basic. You know, I don't consider myself, and I'm not known for my modesty, and I'm not about to start now. I don't consider myself really a guitar player. It's just a thing to do while I'm singing.
You're a great entertainer.
Thank you.
And that's what I think a lot of artists lack today. They go up and they get this thing, I'm a blues star, so therefore I've got to be serious. I've got to put a funny hat on. I've got to only play a dobro. And,
you know, it drives me nuts, because if you check your history where the blues came out of... vaudeville, you know, tent shows, and it was shown when people like Wolf were doing it. Look at Chuck Berry with his duck walk, which he nicked off, you know, was it Guitar Slim?
T-Bone Walker.
You know, Charlie Patton used to throw his guitar up in the air and catch it and keep playing. You know, Wolf would do Dust My Broom, and he'd literally bring a broom on the stage and ape it up to the audience, climb the curtains, you know.
So is that
entertainment?
Is that where Prince gets it from, when he throws that guitar up?
It might well be. You know.
Yeah, for those that haven't seen it, there's a clip on YouTube where an all-star lineup with Prince on there who blows everyone off stage with a guitar solo that goes into the stratosphere. And at the end, he just throws his guitar up. The interesting thing is it doesn't come down.
It doesn't come down. Well, I don't want to spoil the magic, but his roadie catches it. But you don't see that on the camera. It's a little piece of genius. But Prince is a great showman, you know. And you know, and he dances, and I'm not saying I do any of that kind of thing, but it's about show, it's about entertainment, and a lot of that on the British blues scene, I think, has gone missing, and there's a lot of too long guitar solos and too much seriousness, and I'm not saying you have to be a clown on the stage, but I'm talking about communication with the audience, really, and entertaining.
It's called
the
entertainment.
Audience. They haven't just come here to sit there and watch you. Pleasure yourself on stage, let me put it politely. You know, there's got to be some interaction. And I don't mean you have to do a stand-up routine, but, you know, there's more to it than just standing there playing songs, in my opinion.
And you have a guitar in your hand.
I do, yeah. Well, I thought I'd do one I did on the album, on the Candy Store album, but I haven't really done acoustic. It's a song that nearly didn't get on the record because it was so country. But we made it work. Luther Dickinson made it work by putting his gorgeous electric guitar part on it, which made it sound like some Lost Stone song from the 60s. But I'll just do it.
It's one of my favourites.
Thank you. I'll do it as intended, originally intended. It's not my first rodeo. It's not my first ride. Some things you ought to know. It's no use to hide. I've got so many battle scars. I'm sure I deserve. I thank the moon and stars for the time that I've served. My future is in your eyes. Oh, and you know my past. I'll be your first rodeo. You'll be my last. I've been deviled by circumstance. I've learned to my cost. I've gambled on cheap romance. Some won and some lost. The horizon looks clearer now. That there's no place to hide. Be my last rodeo. Yes, it's my last ride. I've seen many a man fall, but I walked out alive. Had my back to the wall, but it seems I survived. And as the sunset turns the sky into rust, I'll be the last man standing when all the little boys have bit the dust. Destiny's dies were already cast. I'll be your first rodeo. You'll be my last.
although the time that we shared sure to go by too fast. I'll be your first rodeo.